Okay. Hello everyone. I hope you enjoyed the healthy eating video that I gave you with the peanut butter snail. I know that my family ate it and we enjoyed it. We are now moving to our second video in which we're going to do some movement activities and exercise activities. This is for K1, 2, and 3. And I will make sure that I distinguish between what K1s can do and 2, 3s. And there's no reason why some of you K1s can't do maybe some of the things that the second, third graders are doing. And second, third graders, you can even start out with what the K1s are doing. Our goal here is to get some exercise and to be working on some skill. I have my daughter here, Caitlin, and my son, Caleb, who are going to be here to assist. So the first thing we're going to start out with our warm-up is we're going to be moving around outside, and we're going to do it without touching anyone. And when they hear the music, they're going to move around. And when the music stops, they stop. So the first thing we're going to do, guys, is when you hear the music, could you just move around this space and show me if you can move without touching anyone's personal space. And as you're walking, make sure that you're keeping your hands to your side. Remember, walking is something that we do at a slow pace. When the music stops, you stop. Are you guys ready for that? Caitlin, yeah. What speed do we walk at? Which slow is a slow speed.
Slow speed.
Say slow speed. Thank you. And Caleb, as we're moving around, do we want to be crashing into other people and falling on the floor, or we are in control of our personal space? All right, let's try this out. Let's do some walking. Notice how they're walking around. Caleb, let's keep your hands to your side with a slight swing. Beautiful. I like that walking. Okay, now you don't necessarily have to go in the same direction. Maybe do some zigzag where you're going back and forth. Katie's kind of doing a circular pattern. Good. And you can do that for as long as you want. It doesn't have to be just 30 seconds. On next one, I want you to stay in your spot, and I want you to show me different ways you can move your arms. Your feet are still, but you're moving your arms in different ways. Can you try that for me, please? Show me different ways of moving your arms. Oh, you got the swimming stroke. Sliding back and forth. Good. I like it. Increasing that heart rate. Got the heart rate beating faster now. Be moving again without touching anyone's personal space. What is something that we can do at a medium speed, a little bit faster? Katie?
Skipping.
Definitely. When we skip, we go at a medium speed. Still in control of our body. And remember that when we skip, we want to lift our knees up. Caleb, could you show me how to skip? Beautiful. He remembers how to skip. Could you show me how to skip, Caleb and Kaylin, without touching anyone? Great. How's that heartbeat? Take your heartbeat. Put your hand on your heart. For my older students, remember you can take your two fingers and put it right there in the middle of your neck at that carotid artery, and you can feel that heartbeat faster. This time, let's stay in our spot. And can you show me if you can just move your feet? Just kind of like dance with the music. Thank you for doing that. Let's do another way that we can move around our space without touching anyone at a medium speed. Katie, can you think of another way we can move without touching anyone at a medium speed?
Gallop.
Gallop, and just out of reference, Can you think of an animal that gallops? A horse gallops. Now, Katie, can you show us how to gallop? Remember, you want to have 1 foot forward and 1 foot back. And gallop. Oh, we want to keep that same foot in front. Keep the same foot in front. All right, here we go. Galloping. Caleb is like a cowboy. He's acting like a cowboy. I like that, Caleb. Thank you. All right. This time, now our heart's really going to go a little bit faster. Can you jog for me? Remember, jogging is something we're doing at a medium speed. We have our head up, our back is straight, and we're swinging our arms. Can we do a slow jog? All right, let's see. I'm looking at my wife's music, and I don't know half these songs that she's got, so we're just going to go with it. All right, we're going to do some jogging. That's great. Now, as they get their next pieces of equipment, we are going to do some volley skills. Hand-eye coordination. Last time we were together, we did an activity where we were tossing balls up in the air and we were trying to catch it. We did it with a partner. We did it, different ways at different levels. So now we're going to do some volley skills. Sports like volleyball and tennis and activities where you're trying to strike an object and keep it up in the air. All right, keep in mind with that fitness activity you just did, you can add some things on your own, different levels, different speeds. You can go forward, backward, zigzag, crisscross, whatever. So those are just kind of a standard for you to get started. Now we're gonna take a look over here at Caitlin, and Caitlin's gonna have a balloon, and we had to move this activity into the garage because it's too windy for a balloon. So kindergartners, first graders, I would start out with a balloon. If you're a second, third grader, you can also use the balloon. The goal here is to keep the balloon up in the air for as many times. So with kindergartners and first graders, start out with 5 times. So Katie, using your favorite hand, can you keep the balloon up in the air 5 times? Notice that she's keeping her eye on the balloon and she's doing a soft tap. She's not trying to strike it. She's not swinging her arm. She's in control it all the time. Good. This time, Caitlin, can you show me if you can use the top of your hand? So flip your hand over and using your favorite hand, can you strike it with the top of your hand? Again, 5, 10 times to see how long you can keep it up in the air. Good. All right, Caitlin, this time, can you use your opposite hand? Now, as we talk a lot, we want to be able to do things with both our dominant hand and non-dominant hand. If you're a basketball player, you need to be able to dribble with your right hand and your left hand. So Caitlin, can you show us your left hand? Or your opposite hand, actually. Good. All right, Caitlin, here's a challenge for you. Can you hit the balloon up in the air with your hand, use your head, and then hit your hand. So you're gonna go hand, head, hand. See if you can keep it up in the air. Hand, head, hit it with your head. There you go, now your hand. Head. Good. All right, Katie, this time, can you hit it up with your hand, hit it with your head, hit it with your elbow, and then your hand. Let's see if we can use different body parts. Head, elbow, hand. Head, keep going.
Keep going, Dad.
Head, elbow, hand. Good. Let's add this time a knee. Hand, head, elbow, knee. Good. Oh, look at that. Look at the different challenges. Oh, good. All right, Katie. This time, hand. See if you can get down low and hit it. Try that. Beautiful. Hand. Use different body parts. Beautiful. And the key here is keeping your eye on the ball all the time. See how many times you can keep it up. Now, if you're home with a brother or sister or mom and dad, you can do the same types of things with a partner. Hitting it back and forth, see if you can keep it up in the air. Good. Excellent. Okay. Let's see how many times you can do that. So kindergartners and first graders, we want you to go ahead and find the balloon and see what you can do with that. Second and third graders, we're going to shift over here to my son, Caleb, and we're going to look at Caleb. And we just found some things that we had around the house. Caleb, we're going to start out with, he just found like a stuffed toy. So Caleb, can you show me some different things you can do with keeping that ball up in the air? Notice that he's using both his right hand and his left hand, using a leg, keeping his eye on the ball. Let's move a little bit closer to our camera. Good control. Excellent. Hand-eye coordination. Ooh, great, Caleb. Now, Caleb, can you go grab the beach ball? It's just a stuffed animal. Find something that you have at home, a ball, a balloon. Now we're going to use a beach ball. Again, same kind of concept, keeping your eye on the ball. Good. You can start at a lower level, and as you get better, keep it up higher in the air. Soft taps. Good. All right, this time, Caleb, can you put your hands together and hit it like a volleyball so you can use it with your hands? Good, keep it up in the air. Good control. Great. Again, now here's something you can do with a partner. If you're at home, you're gonna have a partner and see if you and your mom and dad or a partner can keep it up in the air. Your goal is maybe 10 times in a row, giving it soft taps. Woo! So that's one thing we can do. The other thing is he can toss it to me, and I can hit it back to him, and he catches it. So we're both working on hand. I'm working on striking it, and he's working on catching. Great. Well, that's what we've got for this week. Enjoy those activities. Those will be posted on your classroom pages. Each teacher will post those on a YouTube video. I also have Google Classroom. Keep in mind that I also have a Facebook page in which I'm posting different activities and exercises that you can do. Thank you and have a great week.